The Tibetan Mastiff dog breed was developed centuries ago in the Himalayas. The dogs were originally used as livestock and property guardians. Tibetan Mastiffs can still be found performing that role, but they also enjoy life as family companions and show dogs. Tibetan Mastiffs are a phenotypically unique dog breed that was bred as a flock guardian in the high altitudes of the Himalayas and the Tibetan plateaus. This ancient breed in Tibet has always been so isolated that it is impossible to say how or when Tibetan Mastiffs came to be. We know that for thousands of years they were the mighty guardians of the Himalayas, and it's thought that they were the originator of all modern Mastiffs. They were developed into two types, Doki, who lived in the villages or traveled with nomadic shepherds and functioned as flock guardians, and the Sunki, which were often given to lamaseries and monasteries where they served as guardians for the Tibetan Buddhist monks or the lamas who lived there. Today, the Tibetan Mastiff still performs the job it was created to do. The Tibetan Mastiff is quiet, watchful, and protective of his family, including other pets, and he is inclined to be gentle with and tolerant of children. He has an independent nature with a determined and territorial temperament. The Tibetan Mastiff is not well suited for first-time dog owners or those who are new to guardian breeds. The word challenging is frequently applied to the independent, stubborn breed. He's intelligent and has a strong sense of self, expecting to be treated as an equal, not as a pet. In the right hands, the breed provides unparalleled loyalty, devotion, and protection to his family. But the Tibetan Mastiff requires a special care and handling. He wants to please his people, but he also has his own agenda and must often be reminded of what he's been asked to do. The Tibetan Mastiff is a loyal family guardian who takes his job seriously and is aloof or reserved towards strangers. If your plan is to keep your Tibetan Mastiff as a house pet, early socialization that continues throughout his life will help prevent him from becoming territorially aggressive. Inviting visitors over regularly and taking him to busy parks, stores that allow dogs, and on leisurely strolls to meet new people will help him become more equipped for dealing with social settings. An improperly socialized Tibetan Mastiff has the potential to grow into a liability. Introduce your Tibetan Mastiff puppy to as many people, places, and animals as possible. Keeping interactions positive and going at a pace that keeps your dog comfortable and confident. Even with careful socialization, some Tibetan Mastiffs find it difficult to accept strangers or strange animals, especially those entering the Tibetan Mastiff's property. So be sure to have a strategy for protecting your Tibetan Mastiff from situations where he is likely to fail. The Tibetan Mastiff exercise requirements can be satisfied with 20 to 30 minutes of play in the yard or a half an hour walk. You'll enjoy having another dog to play with, preferably one who comes close to his size. Tibetan Mastiff, like many other purebred dogs, is prone to certain genetic conditions, including hip dysplasia, hypothyroidism, and eye diseases. Responsible breeders test their adult dogs prior to breeding them to avoid passing on genetic diseases. The American Tibetan Mastiff Association requires all member breeders to perform certain health tests on all dogs prior to breeding them, including evaluation for hip dysplasia with the Orthopedic Foundation of Animals, alternatively, a pin hip screening and a thyroid blood panel. Additionally, the American Tibetan Mastiff Association also recommends, although it does not require, that the breeding dogs be screened for elbow dysplasia and certified by OFA's Companion Animal Eye Registry. The Tibetan Mastiff is a rare breed and one that requires an experienced owner. Anyone considering a Tibetan Mastiff as a house pet should reach out to a reputable breeder to talk about what it's like to live with this breed. Some adult Tibetan Mastiff may find themselves in a rescue or animal shelter. More often, though, anyone searching for a Tibetan Mastiff will need to go directly to a reputable breeder. A great place to start is checking out the American Tibetan Mastiff Association. They offer many helpful resources on their website. All right, guys, this is Dogumentary TV. This is the YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Turn on notifications so that you will be among the first to know when I drop a new video. Peace.